الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه. In 2 minutes, inshallah ta'ala, it might seem this is like out of topic. You think that it's not part of it. But I strongly believe it is part of it. And I strongly believe that it comes under the fourth type of ignorance. It comes under حكم الجاهلية. And today is a long weekend, and I know a lot of young people here. And I think it's worth mentioning it, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, this community has been blessed in so many different ways. And we have lots of young people are stable. MashaAllah, I counted them one day we got together. We have almost about between 50 to 60 young people who are ready. They have degree. They are already graduated. They have jobs. They're stable. They're good. They have a good life. Yet, none of them is married. And I'm very serious about this. And when you ask, MashaAllah, you have a degree, you have a job, you have a car, you have money, you have everything. How about the second half of your deen? What is missing? And subhanAllah, with an attitude, no, not yet. No, I'm not ready for this yet. In my humble opinion, this is حكم الجاهلية. If you want to live your life without a sense of responsibility. And what is sad, the reason that I'm mentioning this, just from only the amana of this place, a day will come, some people might come and they say, Ya Allah, Sheikh Abdul Hadi used to be our imam, but he did not educate us about this. That's why I try my best and I speak forward regardless of the consequences, respected brothers and sisters, as long as I speak the truth. Those who refuse to get married and they're not ready for it, and they're stable and they're good, mashallah, and may Allah protect them. But also at the same time, many of them are in haram relationships. Many of them. And I know about it. How do I know? I can't share, but I know. So you're refusing the halal way that Allah has made halal for you. You're closing that door. And then you prefer to live for some time enjoying, following your desires. And I'm not ready because I don't want someone to ask you where I'm going, where I'm coming, when I'm coming, what to do. I just want to enjoy your life. And guess what, subhanAllah, I'm not talking about 18, 19. I'm talking about 20, 25, 26, 27, 28 years old. And what happens is that once you get money and you have money in your pocket and you're stable, you reach the point where I'm independent. I do not need anybody in my life. I just happy. I do whatever I want. I go. But this is, subhanAllah, حكم الجاهلية. And not only the young people, but actually many parents also make it complicated. No, I want him to finish his master's degree first. No, I want my daughter to finish PhD first. She can finish PhD with her husband. Nothing wrong with that. They will complete each other. They will support one another. They will establish a life. So open that door, young people. Open that door. That's a way of rizq that brings you closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. And don't be complicated when you choose your life partner. Perfection belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you need to compromise a little bit, compromise a little bit for the sake of Allah, for the sake of your deen. But if you just decide, I'm happy, not now, not yet. This is, to me, is a serious problem that I think afflicting many youth, not only our community, but many, many, many respected brothers. And it has to be taken very, very seriously. Very, very seriously. If you're good, go for it. If you finished the college, you started your job, go for it. Why are you pending that? Why are you postponing it for? SubhanAllah. This is something very important. Allah Azza wa Jal, or the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, ثَلَاثَةٌ حَقٌّ عَلَى اللَّهِ عَوْنُهُمْ مِنْهُمْ أَنَّاكِحُ يُرِيدُ الْعَفَافِ. There are three types of people whom Allah has promised to assist. What else do you need? Allah has promised to aid and assist. One of them who seeks it through marriage to protect his chastity and to preserve his honor and dignity. Allah will come to their aid. You're not a Razzaq, man. You're not the money maker. You're not the breadwinner. Allah Azza wa Jal is Ar-Razzaq. And your rizq will come to you. Marriage will not take from you. It will give you more and more. It will give you more and more. Just to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and take that step. I'm not pointing my finger at anyone whatsoever. But from the amana of knowledge, I thought this is a great reminder. Since we're talking about these four types of ignorance, and I put this one under the fourth, حكم الجاهلية, just decision making based on ignorance. Because just I don't want to do it. Why? I don't want to do it now. What is the reason? No reason. I just I don't want to do it. I'm not ready for it. This is not right. And this is not the right Islamic way, inshallah. May Allah bless you all. May Allah protect you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us guidance and make us upon the right path. اللهم آمين.